So this is called Sindorondoro. In English, it's called Joe's Hub. Now, as you would notice by now that most of these instruments which are indigenous to Africa are then adopted to make other Western classical instruments as we know them today. So in the family of these instruments, you've got also other instruments that are smaller, like your mbira instrument, which is also called thumb piano, out of which two instruments were born in the Western narrative, out of which the piano was born out of mbira, and the second instrument which was born out of mbira is the harp. You sort of like create from the hollowness of your, so you breathe subtle breathing, and then from that, as this thing plays, it creates this resounding sound that is controlled by how you use your tongue inside. So if you push your tongue back, the sound becomes much more hollow. If you push it in the front, the sound becomes sharp. So your tongue is twisted, is at the back. So this instrument, or the method of this playing this instrument is played commonly by old women. You could imagine that it is an instrument that would be played in a place that is not noisy, since it's an instrument that is not amplified or mic'd in any way. But if it's put against the mic, it can be audible enough and it can create big sound. But the emulating sound from here reminds me of the sounds of the bees, the bzzz of the bees. So it's the same of the bees. And if you can check the frequency over time when you play this thing, when you play, you get attuned to a certain type of natural frequency. I would imagine that naturally so, it would be a meditative instrument because it has the same vibration that you would find in certain chants, like your aum. Because when you do your aum, the lips come together and they vibrate together. So, so sounds like that, like these are the sounds that are inspired by this type of instruments. So these are more of chant-like instruments. They do not have too many tones to it, so you usually have about two or three notes at most, but they are very basic and they are repetitive. So it's all about maintaining a repetitive cycle. So they're about cycle instruments. So this is all we have today with regard to our instrument called Sindorondoro, aka Joe's Harp. Mm-hmm.